I was astonished. I'm into magic. That was cool. I was like a little kid down there just watching. I was enjoying that. Our next speaker. She's a business consultant for NetChex, a technology company located right here in Richardson, Texas. She was awarded the eWomen Network Emerging Leader Award and the Sports Launch 30 Under 30 Award. Please, let's get some applause for Erlina Green.
Thank you. So, hi, my name is Erlina Green. I am recovering from fear, people-pleasing, and lack of courage. Maybe that is the world, maybe that is you, but today's talk will be on your brave versus your courage, your fear, actually. Who are these people? Does anybody know who this guy is? Dietrich Bonhoeffer, right, a German man who fought against the Nazis. What about top right? Martin Luther King, right? These I call our brave unicorns, and of course we have my mom here, a detective here in Dallas, Texas, for 32 years. Now the reason I have these people up here, because if I speak a lot at schools, and if you ask any school-age kid today, who are our brave leaders of today, they hesitate and they pause. And I'd like to say all you all are our brave leaders today. Read this quote, guys, and I want you guys to digest this, and try to understand what this means to you. When I read this quote, what I thought was what we need to do, our job as informed and engaged citizens, is we need to promote great leaders, brave leaders to power, or not be dismayed when we have corruption in our government, right? So what are some of the bases of your fear? Well, again, I was honest enough to mention what some of my fear was, but maybe for you all, it's the opinions of others. So who here naturally cares what other people think about them? Be honest, it's okay, we're friends, okay. Now who here wants to make massive change in their community? Perfect. Well, keep in mind, guys, that those two frame of minds do not coexist, so we've gotta make a decision, and what that decision is to find our brave. You know this guy, he's in your office, he's trying to recover from a high school full of taunts and name calling. He's the ego guy, but what about the popularity? Maybe the reason why you have muffled your brave is because you're still trying to win the popularity t-shirt, right? But some of us, maybe. So what are some of the consequences of muffling our brave, of not speaking out against the things that we see in the world today? What are some of those consequences? Ask yourself that. What I say, some of you guys may know this guy, some, I hope everyone does, we get unruly dictators. Men coming to power saying some crazy things, and we're all sitting back and kind of allowing it to happen if we're not expressing ourselves, if we're not out and out front of it and communicating what we would like to see in government in our community. What about some of these things? I'm sure you guys know mass incarceration is out of control, prejudice, racism. What about institutional corruption? I know some of you guys remember the Jerry Sandusky case a couple of years back, right? But what about the next generation? A lot of the conversations I'm having with kids in middle school, and a lot of conversations that I've even had with adults, is what our parents left us. If they left us dead, if they left us whatever. But have you ever asked yourself, what are we leaving behind for the next generation, right? So what I believe is the key to your brave is your voice, your passionate, informed, articulate voice, getting out, understanding what's going on in the world today and speaking against it. I believe this. I believe where your fear says, my well-being, my safety, my comfort, my stuff, my family, my desires, and my wishes, these are things that I think we have to rid ourselves of, only because what your brave says is you. Your well-being, your comfort, your safety, your voice. What do you want to do with the rest of your life, right? What do you need? What do you want, right? Because if I can help you get what you want, chances are I can probably get what I want too. And so what happens when you find your brave? I believe absolutely everything happens. The world shifts. Change happens. People change. People gain an understanding when you're using your voice to inform. Action activates your brave. Now, I think this is an awesome platform, guys. I think this is an opportunity to talk about the things we're passionate about. But if we don't get up, leave this room, and do something, then we're just talking, right? So I believe action activates your brave. I challenge you all to just take a stance. What do you stand for, right? Ask yourself that. What do I stand for? Speak out against injustice. Speak out against police brutality. Speak out against the pay gap. I like this quote again, the only validation that we need, and of course you guys can read, but I just wanted to remind that you guys are waiting on permission from absolutely no one. You are your permission, so take what you know, take who you are, and use that. Use your voice, find your brave. Thank you all.